Bayanihan was put together 51 years ago when a group of Filipino physicians came to Albany, and whether they were in training or in practice, under the leadership of a pathologist from Albany Med, Dr. Panlilio, he called for a meeting. So they formed a social organization, which is now called the Bayanihan Association of the Capital District. They were away from home, so they needed companionship and cultural nourishment. The primary purpose of this association is to foster a closer relationship between the Filipino community in Albany and to provide year-round opportunity for them to get together and promote the cultural Filipino cultural awareness in Albany, and also to strengthen the bond that binds together the Filipino-American community in Albany. This dinner dance is something different because we, through the leadership of our chairman, Casey Arobang, Joy Anderson, and Dr. Valero, the highlight is to have a fashion show and to inspire everybody and to be able to advertise your business or whatever you do, your profession. We also perform at the different nursing homes to entertain the senior citizens, and we also did a lot of fundraising for the Typhoon Haiyan and Bofa relief operations in Visayas a few years ago. And we try to help those who are in need. We also work hand in hand with the Philippine Consulate, and we try to help them with their missions and their consular outreach programs in Albany. And recently we've been working together with the different organizations in New York and Connecticut and Rhode Island, like the FOSO, Red Point Sitia, Kids Philippines, and locally we have the American Cancer Society that we've been supporting for many years now, and also the Ronald McDonald, we've been helping them.
I was very impressed because everybody came in the nicest clothing that they could possibly. I was awestruck by how beautiful everybody was, and how everybody was so proud of being Filipino. They talked about their lives, they talked about their children.
2012 was the first time I got invited to Bayanihan. Actually met this wonderful person. Then she invited me to this event, and she said she's gonna sponsor me. And she's no other than our reigning president and the longest running president, which is Miss Catherine Dulay Codamon.
Bayanihan to me is everybody gathering together, whether it's around a table, whether it's around cooking a meal, whether it's around all of those activities that we're doing. Bayanihan is just camaraderie and friendship and actually love, because you wouldn't be with people that you didn't love.
To me, Bayanihan is unity, friendship, being compassionate, and putting heart to your hard work.
Personally, for me, Bayanihan is my home. Mm-hmm. It's my second family. My kids grew up and my family being members of the Bayanihan. It gives you that pride, the Filipino pride, to belong to this group of kind-hearted people. And to be able to give back to the community, to the Filipino community here and back in the Philippines. I'm very, very proud to belong to this Filipino community for many, many years. And if I'm still given the chance to be a servant and to serve the Bayanihan Association, I would do it until my last breath. That's how much I love the Bayanihan.
One of the qualities that I absolutely love is you are so welcoming to all our members. You always want to include everybody in every activity. I find that very impressive because not everybody has that talent. So, and the past presidents, like, for example, Dr. David, he's just always welcoming everybody. Hello, how are you? He remembers people's names.
They're always there for you. Mm-hmm. And they always share their time, unselfish love and time for you. Like, I did my best. I give my all when I work. Mm-hmm. I know my husband knows that. He's a witness to all of this. Mm-hmm. So if I work, I really do my best. And I try my best to involve everybody.
Good.
Whether you're a doctor or a teacher or all different professions.
So. For you to be a president, you have to be inspirational. Because the group or association is not gonna go for so many years like Biden did, which is actually the legend. It's one and only in Capital Region. You have to be selfless.
I think that a lot of the presidents, their main goal was to make sure that Biennium succeeded, made sure that the members felt welcome, they made sure that, you know, you were always participating in everything. Dr. Tamayo was the first person that I met who told me about Bayanihan, and he was so excited about the group. He just wanted you to be part of it, and I think that that's one of the main part of that of Bayanihan, is that they want you to be part of that family.
When Typhoon Haiyan happened a few years ago, and we realized that Philippines needed help, I called for a fundraising event right there and then. I got all these members from different organizations like the Film Adirondacks and Film Schenectady and Bayanihan. We were all together in one place, and we were all there working towards a common goal to help those who were affected by Typhoon Haiyan.
What Bayanihan did for my family, at least, is that it sparked a lot of interest in the Philippines. It made my children proud to be Filipinos, or part Filipinos, and they also enjoyed tasting more food than what I was able to cook. So for them to see what I grew up with is something that I feel was really important. It made me really proud as well to be a Filipino. And they always, when they talk to their friends, would tell about the Philippines. So Bayanihan has been a very good influence on my family.
I also would like to mention that the Bayanihan Association played a big role in the proclamation of the first Philippine Independence Day in Albany. It was given to us at the Senate last June.
I think that Bayanihan, being a social association, they actually helped me to execute all my talents without being judged, and actually they're really pushing me to explore more, like show more talents. Now I am one of the chairmen that I never even thought that I would be, because of hard work and mentors, dedication, and all the people behind me, especially the president.
Recently, we were also awarded as one of America's top remarkable organizations. We are very proud to be given this award. And thank you to our guest speaker, Mr. Raymond Smith and Mrs. Lena Rosales Smith, for involving us and giving us that award for the recognition.